It is because the human heart is divided. Families are divided. Society is divided. We are hurting each other simply because we are hurt ourselves. We have been hurt. When we are wounded, we tend to take revenge. We become suspicious of others. We want to defend ourselves. We want to protect our interests. And this sometimes tantamount to violence, hatred, marginalization, injustices, oppressions. So my dear brothers and sisters, it is important therefore that if we want to rebuild this world, a place where we can live in peace and harmony, then it's important that we experience the divine mercy of God. The theme of your celebration precisely is this: yearning, growing, witnessing. So this afternoon, I invite you to reflect how we can journey as a community, showing the divine mercy of God in our lives, and so help each other to grow. At the end of today's gospel, Jesus instructed the apostles, whose sins you forgive, you forgive their forgiven. Whose sins you retain, they are retained. The apostles were sent out to be messengers of peace and reconciliation. And it is important, every Catholic, every real disciple of the Lord must be a peacemaker. Otherwise, you are not a disciple of the Lord. This is part of the Sermon on the Mount, in the Beatitudes, blessed are the peacemakers. We Christians cannot be the cause of division within our community and in society, and last of all, to be in the world, especially if we are leaders. It is important, therefore, that we are called to be witnesses of the mercy of God. In today's scripture reading, Jesus, we are told, he reached out to the apostles who were badly in need of divine mercy. Jesus had already shown his mercy when he died on the cross for us on Good Friday, when he gave his life to each and every one of us. But his death on the cross resulted in the apostles blaming themselves. They were hiding in the upper room because they could not believe what they had done to our Lord, to their Master. They were in fear of enemies within themselves because of the shame, the inability to forgive their failures, and also the Jews, their enemies, were after them. That is why they had no peace. And we too, my dear brothers and sisters, who are the enemies in your life? Why is it you have no peace in your heart? Who is causing you unhappiness? This is something you need to search for yourself. Sometimes we blame others for the lack of peace today. But perhaps what we need most is to begin to discover reasons. It's because we are wounded and we cannot forgive those who have hurt you. Many of you keep grudges in your heart, resentment, anger. I don't see we can celebrate Easter another 100 times if we need to find peace. You will continue to be a prisoner of yourself. Easter is supposed to liberate us for life. Unfortunately, you are still in the tomb if you cannot let go. This is the most unfortunate reality that we struggle with. Perhaps you want to let go, but you cannot let go. And so Jesus came to bring us at peace. In the gospel, twice Jesus said to them, "Peace be with you." Jesus holds no grudges against them. He was the one who reached out to the apostles when they had wronged him. He was not waiting for them to come back to search for him. Jesus, the divine mercy, went out to search for those who had betrayed him. This is the kind of mercy that we are speaking about, because Jesus understands the weakness of his disciples. He knew that they were men. He knew that they were imperfect. He knew that they were struggling. He knew that they were fearful, and so betrayed him. That is why, my dear brothers and sisters, if you want to be merciful, what must you do? First thing, you need to go beyond your pain, your sufferings, your hurts. If you cannot go beyond your hurts, you will be absorbed in yourself. Poor me, how much I have suffered. Poor me, nobody loves me. You see, everybody is so ungrateful to me. Good thing. If you continue to lick your wounds, you will fall into depression. Jesus did not lick his wounds. Jesus showed us his open wounds to the disciples. He went forth with the wounds to meet his disciples. That is what is very important. You need to take the first step to go beyond your pains and your suffering. This is what St. Peter exhorts us in today's second reading, when he reminds the Christians who were under persecution that they were being purified and tested so that they can truly be a witness for Jesus. St. Peter will tell the Christians to dwell on their sufferings, on why they were unjustly persecuted. St. Peter wanted them to go beyond their sufferings to see the glory of God working in their lives. And we too must do that. And you can only do that when you identify yourself. That is why journeying is a very important process in coming to terms with our sufferings. You need to journey. If you journey with people who are suffering, then you stop to think of your own suffering. As a priest, a bishop, Cardinal, I'm truly blessed because I carry the sufferings, your sufferings, the sufferings of my priest on my shoulder. And because I'm so touched with your sufferings, what I suffer is nothing compared to what you are suffering. I do not leave my wounds even though I suffer in carrying this cross, because when I hear your pain, your brokenness, the injustices done to you, the humiliation you suffered, I feel with you. You know, when you feel with the sufferings of others, you stop thinking about your own suffering. And I think the reason why is many of you are in the tomb, looking at your pain. If only you come out, you reach out, then just know that all of us are suffering in different ways, different capacity. The Lord sends you the cross that you can carry. Your cross is not the heaviest that you have. The cross you have is a perfect one. Tailor-made just for you. And how the Lord is so kind that He will tailor-made the cross for you. Not any cross. The one you carry is the cross that you are meant to carry. No other cross. Don't come in and say, Cardinal, let me help you to carry a cross. You cannot. You don't know. You don't have the pain in my shoes. I can't explain to you. You won't understand. You will never understand the Cardinal. But you should. You will never know my pain. You can never know my sorrow. Not even my priest to tell you the truth. Because as a priest, they have their own suffering. As a bishop, I have my own sufferings. And so this is where it's important for us when we think about the sufferings of Christ. Our own suffering. And secondly, when you journey with people's suffering, then you learn not to be patient with them. Now Jesus, divine mercy, showed his tremendous patience with St. Thomas and the apostles. Jesus was waiting. St. Thomas was not there in the first meeting. And he was arrogant. If I don't see the wounds, if I don't die, I will die with him. Oh, how big. That's what many of us. And there was St. Thomas. And the Lord was not agitated. He was not angry. He was not fed up with him. If that is the case, I don't appear anymore. We'll have with you. He didn't say that. He waited. He knew that Thomas was hurting because he had betrayed him. Secondly, he could not believe that Jesus had risen. He was wallowing in his own pain. He was in grief. He can't think properly. Jesus put himself into the shoes of St. Thomas. He waited. And when the time was approaching, he appeared to him again. And that is how we journey with people. You know, you have black Catholics in your house. You have children who are gone wayward. Don't be impatient. Don't force them. Don't scold them. Don't put them down. Because if you put them down, you are again hurting them and they become more reactive. For such people, we need to be patient. We need to be forgiving. We need to be tolerant. As I've said many times, you know, one of the saddest things in the Catholic Church, I feel our Catholics are intolerant of people's failures, of mistakes that people make. They want the church to be run like a military camp. Everything. Come on, this is a church. We have all kinds of people. We can be crazy, the trippy, all kinds. Old, young, we need to pray, we need to wait. The person but it's the right time. And look at the beauty of Jesus.